Hello, in this video, we will talk about atrial pressure during a cardiac cycle. Assuming that you have already watched the video on the cardiac cycle, let's get started. Please note that I will be pointing out the events only in the left atrium to keep the discussion simple. But remember that similar things are happening in the right atrium also. Now let's start our discussion with the atrial systole. During this, atrioventricular valves are open and ventricles are under diastole. So, the contraction of the atria causes a rise in the pressure in the atria. Then, as the atria begin to relax, there is a little fall in the pressure. The next phase is the isovolumetric contraction of the ventricles. Two things happen during this. One, as the atrioventricular valves close, there is a little backflow of blood. And two, as the ventricles contract as closed chambers, there is bulging of atrioventricular valves into the atria. This produces a rise in the atrial pressure. Then the semilunar valves open and ejection of blood starts. The contraction of ventricular musculature during this pulls atrioventricular valves towards the ventricles. This results in a fall in pressure in the atria. During all this, atria are continuously receiving blood. This filling causes a gradual increase in pressure. Meanwhile, the semilunar valves close and ventricles enter into the phase of isovolumetric relaxation. Then the atrioventricular valves open and blood rushes from the atria into the ventricles. This results in a fall in atrial pressure. So this completes the entire cycle. The next cycle begins with atrial contraction. This produces a rise in the pressure as we have already seen in the beginning. So this is how atrial pressure changes during a cardiac cycle. Now let's see all this in a graphical form. Again, we will start with the atrial contraction. This causes a rise in pressure. This rise is also referred to as A wave. Then the onset of atrial diastole produces a fall in pressure. This negative wave is also referred to as the X wave. Then comes the isovolumetric contraction of ventricles. At this point, backflow of blood and bulging of atrioventricular valves produces a rise in pressure. This is referred to as the C wave. Then during ejection, ventricular musculature pulls atrioventricular valves towards the ventricles. This produces a fall in atrial pressure. This wave is referred to as X1 wave. The gradual fill of atria during diastole produces a rise in pressure, a wave called V wave. This is followed by the opening of atrioventricular valves and rushing of blood from the atria into the ventricles. This causes a fall in pressure, and this wave is called the Y wave. Then the next cycle begins with the atrial contraction and we see A wave again. So this is all about pressure change in the atria during a cardiac cycle. Now let's have a quick summary. Atrial systole causes a rise in pressure. The onset of atrial diastole causes a fall in pressure. During isovolumetric contraction of ventricles, closure of atrioventricular valves and their bulging into the atria causes a rise in the pressure. During the ejection phase, pulling of atrioventricular valves into the ventricles produces a fall in atrial pressure. Gradual filling of blood into the atria causes a rise in the pressure. And during rapid ventricular filling, rapid exit of blood causes a fall in pressure. That's it for this video. If you feel this video will help your friends and colleagues, please share it with them too. And don't forget to subscribe because lots more to come. At Nonstop Neuron, learning medical concepts is as easy as watching cartoons. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.